So let's talk about some engine oil basics. One of the frequent questions we hear is, what is in an oil? The answer is that oil and automatic transmission fluids are made up of 80 to 85% base oil and 15 to 20% additives. Base oils come in two varieties, mineral and synthetic. Mineral oil is produced from refining petroleum or vegetable oils, and synthetic is produced from a chemical synthesis or intense refining. Also, specific types of base oils have ideal properties for gasoline, kerosene, or lubricants. Additives then enhance and add positive features to base oils. When we look at the differences between mineral, which is better known as conventional oil, and synthetic, it is easy to see, as illustrated in this picture, that mineral oil consists of very irregular or inconsistent sized molecules, whereas synthetic oil molecules are more uniform. This leads to the fact that synthetic oils simply perform better than conventional oils. Here you are looking at a simple base oil chart broken out into groups 1 through 4. We have also listed some of their uses and attributes. As you can see, group 1 is a low-grade conventional oil with a low viscosity index, which I will discuss more regarding viscosity index in a moment. Group 2 is where the automotive world starts to be involved with conventional oil and synthetic blends. Then we move on to group 3 and group 3 plus, which are the base oils that we use at ENEOS because of their high quality and performance features. Group 4 base oils are commonly known as PAOs and are used depending on performance requirements. One of the advantages of using higher grade base oil is because they contain less sulfur, and that is important because sulfur creates harmful byproducts. Engine oils are multifunctional fluids that perform many tasks. Most of us think of oil simply as a lubricant, but never consider the other necessary functions, such as cooling, cleaning, sealing, and anti-corrosion. How does oil do that? Oil seals gaps between piston walls and rings. It helps cool by absorbing heat and then transferring it. Rust prevention is accomplished with additives. As the oil circulates through the engine, it picks up contaminants that would otherwise do harm and holds them in suspension until the oil is changed. Lastly, the lubricating properties allow moving parts to slide smoothly, thereby reducing friction. Although all oils have these basic properties, there can be vast differences in how well each oil performs these important functions. The proper combination of base oils and additives combine to reduce friction in all areas. We have friction anywhere there is metal-to-metal contact, and this requires additives to reduce friction in those areas. Secondly, we have fluid friction that comes about due to the fluid viscosity. So again, high-quality base oil is essential to minimize this type of friction. Engine oil contains many different additives with various functions. So here's a quick look at the various additive packages and those functions. Detergent keeps engine parts clean in high temperature areas. Oxidation inhibitors prevent oxidation and rust. Viscosity modifiers increase viscosity index in the oil. Dispersants keep engine parts clean in low temperature areas. Friction modifiers obviously reduces friction and wear on moving parts. Extreme pressure agents controls wear on engine parts at very high temperatures and loads. So additives can provide new features to oil or enhance features already present in the base oil.